watching, I want to show you a really nice way to upgrade your cakes for the holidays that are coming up. Just using a nice chocolate wrap, it's a little bit easier than you may think. Now, everybody carries parchment paper at the house, every baker should. What I've done here is I basically just folded it over and to the height of the cake that I'm going to be working on, and then I just used a sharp paring knife to make it the right height of the cake. I'm just going to show you wrapping this dummy, and then I'm going to unwrap this other one I did ahead of time. What I did was, you can see how I wrap it around. It might be a little difficult with white on white, but it's a little bit longer in the circumference than the cake should be, and that's fine. I'm going to show you how to work with that. I'd rather it go completely around the cake than come up short. So what I'm going to do, now that I have the right height and the right length for my parchment paper for the cake that I'm working with, I'm going to just lay it down on a lined piece of my countertop to work with. Now, I have a parchment cone. I have another video on a really easy way to make parchment cones. And if you just have parchment paper at the house, you can certainly cut those really, really easily. So I've got a little bit of white chocolate here. I'm just going to put this in. Do one more. Not too full because I don't want it squeezing out the top. And then I'm just going to fold that down and make sure it's squeezing out nicely with no lumps. That looks good. Now, I have a fork nearby. Okay, you can use any kitchen fork, nothing fancy. And what I'm going to do is just kind of start making swirls so it falls on the parchment. And it go over the edge, that's fine, that's why I lined underneath it. And before it sets up, go ahead and take your fork, and you can do any design you want. Some people will do hashes, but I think dragging this fork through has a really cool kind of snowy, wintry effect, which I think works really well for winter. So just make sure you don't have any straight lines left there. Go every direction that you can. Make sure it's covered. You can always add a little bit more white chocolate if you think it's not covered enough, but I think that's going to be plenty. So what I want to do is give that a minute just to set up so that when I put the chocolate on behind it, it's not going to smear it. So just give that like a minute to set up. We'll be right back. Okay, so now that my first color has set up, I have my chocolate blend. This is a milk chocolate and dark chocolate blended together, but just use whatever chocolate you want. I'm just going to pour in a nice thick line right down the middle of my parchment. Make sure that you have plenty, because if you come up short, it's really hard to go back and fix it, because you're going to be putting this on the cake while it's still pliable. Now, while I'm spreading this out, I'm just using an offset spatula here. I'm going to spread it over the edges. But while I'm spreading this out, let me point out that this cake that I'm going to be pulling the wrap off here in a second, I went ahead and iced that. I'm working on a dummy cake over here, so I'm not going to bother icing it. It's going to stick nicely. I'll show you how to wrap it around the cake. But when you're working with a cake, go ahead and assemble it and ice it with buttercream as you normally would. Okay, so that's completely covered. And you notice I'm wearing gloves because this does get really, really messy. I'm going to set my cake here. And then I'm just going to pull up on the corners. Try to keep it from flopping on itself. And then you're going to just wrap it around. It's a dummy cake again, so it's light. So I'm going to wrap it around the back. I'm going to pull this around so you can see it a little bit better. And then I'm going to pull it all the way and just go ahead and go past that point. I'm not going to worry about that. It's going to break off pretty easily later. If you want to, you can take a fondant smoother or just take your hands really gently and make sure it's nice and not rippled going all the way around. Now, this will set up for probably, I don't know, 10, 15, maybe 20 minutes, and it should be ready to unwrap. But I've got one ready to go. Let's take a look at this one. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and unwrap this one. You'll notice that this one comes up about half an inch, 3/4 of an inch above the cake. Later on, you can decorate that with maybe some chocolate dipped strawberries or chocolate dipped cherries, whatever kind of floats your boat, maybe something, some mint leaves, something pretty to make that a decorative cake. This one is the height of the cake, obviously. It's going to be perfectly even. I would suggest you don't go any higher than this just because, number one, it can kind of flop over the top of the cake when you're putting it on. And number two, it just can break really easily when you're transporting it and carrying it around. So about a half an inch, 3/4 above is as high as you want to go. Okay, so the parchment has set up, and I'm just going to go ahead and start peeling this. And when I get around to the front, I'll show you about that overlap. So you just want to make sure that releases cleanly. And it just peels right off and leaves that decoration. Okay, and here's going to be our tricky point. So depending on how thick you spread this, if it's a nice thin coat, typically you can just kind of pull it and it'll snap. Let me see if I can do this from the right-hander side. If not, then you may need to give it a little bit of support with a long blade. just so it doesn't break past that point. You're kind of creating the break for it. And if it gives you a lot of trouble, you can go back with a hot knife and kind of score that a little bit. But see how that pops right off with just a little bit of support from behind it? And then just make extra sure that you haven't overlapped any chocolate. I got a little bit that oozed out here that wants to keep that parchment. So then what you can do, once you have your chocolate peeled off, you can move this to a clean board for presentation. But that's my chocolate wrap cake. Again, you can make any kind of design you want with it. Hash marks, you can use different colors. Some hearts might be nice for Valentine's Day, but I kind of think this fork pulled through the white chocolate gives it a nice kind of snowy effect for Christmas. So I'm gonna put some chocolate covered cherries on that and call it a day. It's an easy way to dress up a holiday cake. Thanks for watching.